Your first look tonight at a multi-million dollar project to bring criminals to justice.
This spring, we told you how Douglas County is moving and upgrading its CSI unit from the sheriff's headquarters to the old Thomas Fitzgerald Veterans Home.
Well, the I-Team gives you an inside look at the work being done and who's paying for it.
They're trying to keep the integrity of or the aesthetics of the old building.
The old Thomas Fitzgerald Veterans Home has a new mission, fighting the war on crime. And Captain Steve Glant from the Douglas County Sheriff's Department shows how it'll help. Beginning on the first floor, where the canine units get about 5,000 square feet of space.
It'll be an indoor and outdoor run kennel.
On the second floor, twice as much room, dedicated to a new upgraded CSI unit.
This will give us plenty of room to examine all kinds of evidence.
Using all kinds of high-tech equipment for chemical analysis, DNA testing. The cost for it all, about $4 million.
We will be able to entirely pay for the project out of seized assets rather than taxpayer money.
That's right. Sheriff Tim Dunning says not a single penny is going to this renovation. It's being paid for with money like this. This is $1.2 million seized this spring during a traffic stop, hidden in a semi under some cheese. But according to Dunning, there were no smiles when he told the county commissioners about plans for all the renovations.
I was getting all kinds of cross-eyed looks like, I can't believe you want to build something in this down economy. But then when we talked about paying cash, they were pretty ecstatic about it.
The sheriff's department gets about 80% of the money seized, and it's added up over the years.
I think I could say $7 to $8 million without blinking an eye.
The drug seizure money has allowed us to equip our people with the best stuff we can get.
The money bought the sheriff's ESU, or Emergency Services Unit. It's used by the department's SWAT team. Between the van and the equipment, like weapons, shields, and battering rams, the price tag hits about $150,000. Again, footing the bill, drug runners.
If it dries up and goes away along with the drugs, that'd be a great thing, but the reality is it probably won't.
So the crime fighters say, why not capitalize on that? Call it a win-win-win for taxpayers, law enforcement, the people who get hired to do the work. But a definite lose for the crooks.
Number one, I was able to take something, you know, from you and put it to work against you, you know, and at the same time, it's not costing, you know, the people that I work for a dime.
Dunning tells me seized money also bought cars for the undercover narcotics unit and other vehicles. Now, this new CSI and canine unit areas are scheduled to be complete early next year.
More than 1,000 Harley-Davidson workers are in a lose-lose.